The kitchens in our homes are like chemical laboratories. There's so much science in our kitchen activities. Let's explore the secrets of science in our kitchen. Our topic today: how does milk turn into curd? We all eat curd, but do we know what it is and how it is made? Let's make curd and learn the chemistry hidden in it. To make curd, we take lukewarm milk, add a bit of curd and mix it well. We let it rest for a few hours. And as if by magic, milk turns into curd. But how and why does this happen? Let's do an experiment to find out the reason. We need 3 bowls, milk and curd. In one bowl, we take very cold refrigerated milk. In the second bowl, lukewarm milk. And in the third bowl, we have very hot milk. The 3 bowls are identical with the same quantity of milk. The only difference is the temperature. Now, let's add a little curd to each bowl and stir them well. Cover all the 3 bowls after mixing the curd. Let's keep the first bowl with cold milk in the refrigerator. The second bowl with lukewarm milk outside. And the third bowl with very hot milk in another vessel containing hot water. Let's leave the 3 bowls covered and undisturbed for a few hours. After a few hours, time to check. Has the milk in the 3 bowls turned into curd? The milk kept in the refrigerator is still milky. It has not become curd. The bowl with lukewarm milk left outside has turned into curd. The third one with very hot milk has separated into some watery liquid and white granular substance. Let's understand what happened in the 3 bowls. Why is it that only the lukewarm milk in the second bowl turned into curd? Milk turns into curd due to a biochemical process. This process is called fermentation. So, what is fermentation? Fermentation is a process in which bacteria or other microorganisms break down substances and produce new substances. Milk contains a protein called casein and a sugar called lactose. If we could look into curd very closely, we would find thousands of bacteria in it. These are lactobacillus or lactic acid bacteria, and they are responsible for turning milk into curd. When we add curd to milk, these bacteria produce energy for themselves by breaking down lactose sugar and change it to lactic acid. This lactic acid reacts with the milk protein casein. It changes the molecular structure of casein. The globular shape of casein changes into long chains. These chains get entangled and slowly set and form curd. Lactobacillus bacteria multiply very quickly and are able to convert all the milk into curd in a few hours. This is how our milk turned into curd. Bacteria need specific conditions to grow, like temperature, neither very hot nor very cold. For bacteria to multiply and grow well, the temperature should be between 37 degrees and 50 degrees Celsius. Now, Can you guess why the milk in the first and the third bowl did not change into curd? The first bowl had very cold milk. At this low temperature, the bacteria could not grow well and break down the lactose sugar. So, curd did not get formed. In the third bowl, the high temperature killed the bacteria. The hot milk curdled and the curd did not form. Now you must have guessed why it is difficult to set curd in winter. Curd has thousands of bacteria and an altered form of protein. That makes it healthier for us in comparison to milk. Curd is also easier to digest. You may be wondering, if bacteria make us ill, how can curd having millions of bacteria be healthy for us? All bacteria are not our enemies. Only few of them make us sick. Lactobacillus bacteria is good for us. It keeps us healthy. Fermentation occurs inside our body cells too. Food gets easily digested because of fermentation. Did you know that our intestines have countless such bacteria that help us digest our food? Time for a question. Can you name some more types of food that are prepared with the help of fermentation? Remember, our kitchen is to be explored not just for food, but for science too.